Hello, friends, and welcome to another video. Today, I'm going to be dressing like we did 40 years ago, in 1977. 1977 was the year that brought us Annie Hall, the first personal Apple computer, Space Mountain, and the births of Kanye West, Shakira, and Chuck E. Cheese. From Burt Reynolds' mustache to Chewbacca's facial hair, 1977 was a year of lining up to Boogie at Studio 54, as well as to see Luke Skywalker destroy the Death Star for the first time ever. While ABBA was crooning about dancing queens and some dude named Fernando, an entire movie was being produced about Arnold Schwarzenegger's biceps. In regards to what we were wearing, it was a year of flared pants, matching his and hers blouses, polyester everything, and all of this floofy hair. From the Farrah flip to the fluffy bowl cut, 70s hair definitely had its moments. So once again, Kaylee Melissa, a super talented hairstylist and YouTuber, agreed to aid me in my quest to become a foxy 70s mama. So with some assistance and after consulting a few fashion magazines, these 500-page JCPenney catalogs, and my mom, I think I've managed to put together three outfits that echo some of the iconic looks of the time. As always, I'm going to be focusing mostly on American fashion, though as we know, ABBA was from Sweden. So 1977, what happened and what we wore. So for my first outfit, I whipped out the polyester and a touch of suede for a business casual pantsuit look. My hair is floofing and the suede is swishing, and we're all just going together. This outfit was inspired by several looks from the JCPenney catalog, as well as some leading ladies from TV and film, including Mary Tyler Moore, Annie Hall, the Charlie's Angels, and the OG Wonder Woman herself, Linda Carter. Well, her alter ego Diana Prince.
It's not working!
Not literally Wonder Woman supersuit, but that thing is pretty fly.
I'm not Wonder Woman.
I tried.
This outfit includes leather loafers, brown flared pants, this brown belt, a striped button-down shirt, a tan suede jacket, this orange ascot, and these giant glasses.
These like earthy and orangey tones kind of make me feel like Velma from Scooby-Doo.
Oh yeah.
Yes, everything is some type of brown or earth tone. The 70s color palette was very much a reaction against the bright psychedelic colors and rainbows of the 60s.
I've kind of got like Velma glasses and orange, shaggy pants, and Fred ascot.
Just a little bit of the whole gang.
This is the shaggy run. He goes.
Well, how do you do the Velma run?
Probably the same way. Yeah. They're all animated exactly the same.
They all kind of like are leaning over.
Yeah,
and like
leaning forward.
This outfit could work for an undercover agent or as office wear, but variations on this pants and blouse outfit seem to be everywhere, as pants became more mainstream as women's wear.
You kind of look like you're someone from Argo.
Like an ambassador.
Hanging out with Ben Affleck.
Ooh, not that part.
As little as 10 years earlier, women wearing pants in everyday business or formal settings was not exactly socially acceptable, but in the late 60s and early 70s, many women began wearing more unisex, less typically feminine clothing, and by the late 70s, pants were everywhere. In denim, polyester, and attached to halter tops in disco jumpsuits.
These aren't bell bottoms, they're more like boot cut flares, but like, I am going to the office, I'm not going to the disco. Quite yet.
This entire look was also worn by guys too. Flared pants, loafers, and wide lapel shirts were popular amongst everyone. And so was this wavy hairstyle with side-swept bangs.
Today, I'm gonna make you look like my mom in high school. She had these long, lippy bangs, and basically everything is curled out away from the face. So I'm gonna get your hair to have as much fluffiness as I can, and then we're using another toupee.
Couldn't go another video without another toupee.
No, we need the toupees. They're important.
For my makeup, I went with gold and bronze eyeshadow, mascara, a bit of blush, and a neutral lip color.
I'm not too sure about the eyebrows. I think I might have too much eyebrow for the 70s, but the glasses mostly conceal those, so that's good.
This outfit really does make me feel like I'm some type of investigative reporter.
See, this is why you wore earth tones as a detective. You blend right in with the fall foliage.
Oh, you were trying to blend in? That was your detective move? Who are you investigating right now?
You.
Me?
Yes, that's what I said, you. Damn it.
I think maybe it's the glasses or the old camera that I found.
Can I help you? You're under arrest.
You're under arrest.
But regardless, it was fun. And I would definitely wear this ascot again.
Now that I've double knotted it, it's never coming off.
Yeah, snip it off.
Leave my ascot alone!
For my second outfit, I threw on a leather jacket and stuck some safety pins in my ears for this punk street fashion look.
I think I'm like trying to figure out like how angry I should be.
You have to be mad that there's any form of government at all.
In 1977, the punk movement was growing concurrently in New York and in London, led by major music acts such as the Ramones, Blondie, the Sex Pistols, and The Clash.
If you're an American punk, you do this. But if you're a British punk, you do this.
Rude.
I don't know if you can do it with both hands. Actually, I don't know which hand it is.
Isn't it your like bow hand?
I think it's this one.
When's the last time you shot an arrow?
Never.
Though punks on different sides of the pond had slightly different styles, the underlying ideology was mostly the same. Mainstream music sucked, mainstream politics sucked, hippies sucked, and maybe we should give anarchy a chance.
And in this case, you're basically angry at the Greeks.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, how dare you create democracy? Who created currency there next?
How would we exchange goods?
We'll exchange pins.
Okay.
I guess that's currency, damn it. It's hard to function without
government. That's the definition of currency.
For this outfit, I chose these chunky-soled combat boots, fishnet stockings, a distressed plaid skirt, this Sex Pistols t-shirt, this black leather moto jacket, a dog collar necklace, and as I mentioned before, a few strategic safety pins and band pins.
Maybe it was like how many shows you had went to, or just like how many bands you wanted to rep. It's almost like a Boy Scout badge.
Yeah.
Punk scouts.
And for my makeup, I was inspired by Siouxsie Sioux of Siouxsie Sioux and the Banshees, who was a major style icon of the London punk scene. Punk fashion and music leaned heavily on nostalgia for 1950s rock and roll, bringing back elements like the greaser's leather motorcycle jackets and straight leg denim jeans. But this time, they were distressed and repurposed, almost as if the punks had dragged them out of their proverbial grave.
I am an anarchist.
I feel like I really look the part, but I'm not doing so good at acting the part.
Yeah, that's hardcore.
In general, the aesthetic of punk was all about shock value. Facial piercings of many varieties, bold makeup, vertical hair, ripped pants, plaid pants, no pants, and an abundance of metal chains. Though some commonalities emerged, the general style theme was just DIY or go naked.
I need to take one of these off and make it an earring.
How much can you feel your hair in the wind?
I can feel it. Feels like a giant cotton ball.
Yeah, it looks like a giant cotton ball.
This hairstyle in particular is inspired by images of women attending punk music shows, as well as everyday street looks.
Yes, my goal is to make you several inches taller today. I'm doing a wig first so that I can get the hair slightly shorter to give me a better chance at fully defying gravity.
How much gel did you put in this thing already, Kaylee?
All the gel I had. You heard me say a lot of gel. What I said was, all the gel.
And though many punks had shorter hair, it seems like longer hair could also be styled straight up or in some kind of orb around your head.
Like the 80s hair is kind of like Restoration England, and this one is kind of like pre-revolution France. It's like a very counterculture twist on Rococo.
Yeah.
I agree. Oh. Good, I like that attitude. Slam it shut.
Though it was new in the 70s, the punk aesthetic is a pretty timeless counterculture look.
Something that is kind of interesting to me is how similar this look is to my 2007 like emo slash scene look. Like it's just, I feel like I'm like the mom. I'm just like dropping out emo babies left and right.
Most people avoided me in this outfit.
Sugar, spice. Everything nice.
But besides that, I did very much enjoy kicking stuff with my thick-soled combat boots.
Consider yourself lucky. That could have been your shin.
Yeah, don't kick me.
And headbanging in Hot Topic.
I was so nervous to headbang because I thought that it would like get rid of all the height, but maybe in fact that's what it needs.
Oh, yeah.
It needs to just be like whisked around kind of.
That's how you do it by yourself.
Yeah, exactly. You just put all the gel in it and then you just almost like put it in a blender. You're like.
A place that no doubt many old school punks would not frequent, but they arguably helped build. For my final outfit, I jumpsuited up for a night on the town disco look.
It is a little before dusk, so it is a little early for disco fever, but the sun shall soon be setting.
The 1970s going out look traded in the miniskirts of the 60s for full-length dresses, flared pants and jeans, and other easy-to-groove-in garb.
I feel like this outfit is very much made for dancing, but not necessarily for going to the bathroom, and not really for much else.
For this outfit, I'm wearing a black jumpsuit with a halter top, flared leg and teardrop-shaped cutouts, a gold brooch, golden dancing sandals, a gold gold purse, and these gold and black accessories, inspired by disco icons like Donna Summer, Diana Ross, and a little bit of the Bee Gees.
I don't know what I'm doing, I lost the beat.
For my makeup, I chose this bright blue eyeshadow, blush, and lip gloss.
I think I've already eaten my lip gloss off. But the eyeshadow's still there, I haven't eaten that yet.
No.
For my hair, we went for the full Farrah flip.
My hair is fauceting away, just like a fountain that is being released from a faucet. I'm just trying to work Farrah Fawcett in there somewhere. It's really not working.
It's coming across.
Okay, there you go.
Farrah Fawcett, a Charlie's Angel and style icon, had a very specific wide layered look, but in general for disco hair, the bigger and curlier, the better. For this look, Kaylee found a full diagram of how to get the exact Farrah flip, from the curls, to the wings, to the feathery, feathery bangs.
I'm not exactly sure what types of moves I should be doing. I feel like the only one I really know is this one.
Yeah, it's classic.
This feels right. This one feels like I'm grooving. To the windows, to the wall, to the wall. The sweat dripping down time.
Although discos were known for their anything goes mentality, dance by yourself, dance naked, ride a white horse, tonight I decided to go out with a disco partner. For Tyler's outfit, we went full John Travolta.
Hey, will you watch the hair?
From the hair, to the red blouse, to the flared pants, all the way down to the super tall platform dancing shoes, and all the way back up to the exposed chest hair.
Tyler, what are you eating?
I have no idea. It's good, it's like a giant Twinkie.
We couldn't find a real disco club nearby, but there was a roller disco that was open on a Monday night, so we went to go try out some of our moves.
It's time to boogie.
The disco scene was going strong in 1977, with the opening of Studio 54 in New York and the massive success of the movie Saturday Night Fever.
I'm ready to dance. I'm very bad at roller skating, but you gotta try. I'm just gonna hold the rail.
But a few short years earlier, it was more of an underground movement. Disco finds its roots in the gay club scene of New York in the late 1960s. Originally as a place where many people from different marginalized communities would get together and dance it out. But by the middle of the decade, disco became mainstream.
I'm very bad at it, but it's fun.
But you know, there weren't as many tall Scandinavians in the 70s.
That's not true, what about ABBA?
And growing to be a $4 billion industry with over 10,000 discotheques open across America by 1978.
Woo! I'm definitely getting better.
What are you doing? Is that a dance move?
The roller disco in particular was an emblem of the late 70s. It seems like roller skating in general became popular, and so we all had the idea that bringing the two together would be a match made in heaven.
Here on the ski floor, you must remain skating.
Regardless, it was the closest we could find to a true disco club, as well as a great place to showcase me almost falling on my ass multiple times. And there was a disco ball. So I think it counts.
I didn't do that great, but I didn't fall.
We got some good dancing in there.
Yeah, exactly. I would definitely do this again. I would come back for sure.
Yeah.
So those were my 1977 outfits. An additional bonus outfit that I've been wearing the entire time is this jumpsuit that my mom bought and believes she wore in 1977. She and my grandma also sent a couple of other outfits that they believe are late 70s and maybe early 80s. Overall, I really enjoyed styling outfits around the 1977 aesthetic. Of all the things in these looks, there definitely is some stuff that's in style today. To be honest, the punk outfit is something that people would and do wear pretty much from head to toe today. And I also think that a lot of retailers are referencing the 70s in their fall and winter clothing lines. For me, I'd like to bring back the ascot.
I was walking with so much purpose, my ascot just blew open.
And also the roller skates. I wasn't very good at it, but I feel like I could get better. And again, I could always use more chest hair from Tyler. I do like the John Travolta hair, but I mostly like the Tyler hair. And by that I mean chest hair. This is his chest. Thank you guys so much for watching. Once again, a huge thank you to Kaylee and Melissa for helping me out with my 70s do's. I've linked her channel below, so make sure to go check it out. She's very talented, and she even transformed into Jon Snow one time. If you liked that video, make sure to smash that like button, and if you want to see more videos like this, make sure to smash that subscribe button. And if you've already smashed that subscribe button, make sure to also smash that little bell icon in the middle to turn on post notifications so you get a notification every time that I post. Here are my social media handles, and make sure to check out my next feed. I do a lot of daily vlogging and Q&As on there. A big shout out to Jam for watching. Thanks for watching, Jam, and I will see you guys next time. Thank you.